Both teams come into this one riding high after back-to-back wins. Mr. Vitale, this third-round game should prove to be a tight one between the San Diego State Aztecs and the USC Trojans.
Both teams need to forget about the wild crowd here and play basketball.
The Trojans are getting a very tough opponent tonight, Dick. What's the key to victory for them?
Hey, they've got to do the simple things out there, and they should be okay. Number one, the point guard has to be the floor general. It's up to him to ensure that his team executes and has efficiency on both sides of the floor. Next, set good interior screens to free up your big men on the block. Look to the inside first. Third, get busy battling for the boards. Winning teams always rebound well.
Well, partner, I say let's get to the action on the court and we'll see how this one plays out.
I'll tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on the box.
He got the steal. The pressure got to the ball handler.
Awesome ball pressure. It was too much for him and he lost possession.
Oh my goodness, that was unbelievable, baby.
Patience by the dribbler being shown as the offense is reset.
Trying to go inside.
That one's blocked from behind.
Great rotation by the D. I love it.
Both teams looking to get things going here. They look to get it to the inside. Moving it around the perimeter. And that's going to be an offensive foul for sure.
What a great job defensively. What a super job. Great footwork. And he really draws the charge. Dump it inside.
Here's a double team. Got a guy right up on him. Shoots it. It's good. Dumps it in. Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
Showing great patience as he waits for the reset of the offense. Gave it up. The point guard takes the feed. Keeps the dribble as they set it up again.
Nice fake. Nice high post screen.
The shot from the baseline. Way off target.
This defender is resilient. Still applying pressure.
There appears to be a mismatch in the post.
Can they get him the ball, though?
Off the rim and no good. Trying to feed inside. Lagona comes up with it. Nice to have you along with us tonight. Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews alongside. I'm Brad Nessler. We got a good one going. With the jump hook. Can't get the shot to go. There was no doubt about that one. The Aztecs have a mismatch in the post.
It's definitely a mismatch.
Well, the defender goes, he blocks the shot.
Look at that. That's unbelievable, baby.
Way off target. The ball goes out of bounds. You talk about a packed house. Look at this crowd.
I tell you, coach's dream, baby. This gives you that edge.
On the dribble, gives it up for two. It'd be nice if he could get some assistance out there. That young man is doing it all for his team right now.
Right now, it's a one-man show. The other players need to step up.
Way out on top, controlling the ball. From the top of the key, off the rim and no good. Problem with that, when you front, if you don't get some backside help, you're in trouble.
Well, you got to get help because you got to see ball, man. That's essential when you play out there in the front.
Keeps the dribble as they regroup. Here they come with a double team to stop it. He does the sweet fake shot. Up, he keeps the concentration off the contact for the score. look to perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
And off the mark. Trying to feed the low block.
A lot of good things happen when you bring the ball down to the inside.
Goes up for two. Perfectly executed. Gave it up. On the dribble, gives it up. The ball goes out of play. Let's go to the third member of our broadcast team. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, the leading team down here is very relaxed. I'm down by their bench, and the coaches are reminding them, despite the score, try and remain focused. Remember, it's the first half. Anything can happen, guys.
Thanks, Aaron. Tries for two.
I tell you, once you get deep position like that, it's automatic.
With a stop here, there will be sheer pandemonium in the stand. The power forward gets the pass. Nice move with a face-up.
I tell you one thing, Brad, I like guys that are versatile in that post. Facing up is a way to take advantage of three basic moves.
For the bucket.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Didn't like what he saw in the post and reverses the ball. Goes in.
Pressure that basketball. Help one another. Communicate.
That spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beats him to the spot.
The shooting guard with the ball. Had a guy in the post but elected to reverse the ball. Wynn picks up the foul. Oh, and you can see the frustration as he picks up the foul.
Oh, that's a bad, bad foul right there, Brad.
Gave it up. They go with the entry pass on the post. Turnaround jumper. The center takes the pass, tries to turn, and the defense comes up with a play.
What a terrific play to stop that spin move.
For two, they still don't score.
Get that sucker out of the game, man.
Too much. That's a foul. Oh, and he's not going to be happy with that call.
What a silly foul right there, but look at his face. His facial expression tells it all.
He's got the man in the high post if he can get it there.
That was a great, great effort right there. Trying to play that passing lane. Anticipating really well.
Working it around the perimeter. They move it into the front court. Oh, and you can tell by the look on his face, he wasn't expecting the whistle on him.
Wow, look at the facial expression. He says, me? Coaches love it when their team gets to the free throw line. It's an opportunity to put points on the board and potentially get the opponent in foul trouble.
Second one, no good.
Hey, you don't have to be a space eater, a.k.a. a big guy to get on board. You just have to be relentless.
That spin move not successful, Dick.
I tell you, great job on the defense, not allowing him to make that turn. What a great steal. Defensive player was really right on top of that basketball.
On the dribble, gives it up, picks off the lazy pass. The point guard gets the ball. Chase fakes the shot. Gets the feed down low. Now the turnaround jumper.
Nothing but nylon. Nice, smooth turnaround jumper. The only negative, he's falling away. If he misses, he's got no rebounding ability.
goes up for two. And he missed. Tries for two. And off the mark. For the bucket. Perfectly executed. Dick, they're doing a great job defensively down here in the low block.
I tell you, what a great job on a defensive player. He's winning the battle on the interior because he's beating him to the spot.
He shoots from right of the circle, way off target. Defensively down on the low block, and there's a steal.
Terrific job anticipating, reading the offense, and making that steal.
Two. Up. Easy one. Isolated on the outside. They work it around the arc looking for the open jumper. Goes up for two. They still don't score. He gets the bucket. For two, doesn't go.
The strip of a basketball got a little too fancy, too much mustard there, baby.
With a final shot, and it's no good from 3-point range. At the half, the Trojans trail by one. It's been a tight one thus far, Mr. Vitale. What play do you think set the tone here tonight?
Watch here. Pounding the ball inside like you see. In this highlight, we'll take a lot out of a team on defense. I expect to see more of the same from both teams in the second half.
Let's get back down to the action where it looks like the two teams are all set to start the second half. USC has been giving up the ball like it's worth nothing.
Yeah, Brad, I don't know if I've ever seen a team turning over the ball like this. They're basically telling their opponents to keep attacking them.
Let's check in with Erin Andrews and what she's got in store for us, Erin.
Well, Brad and Dick, as we know, this is it. Now, I could hear from both teams' huddles the excitement. They are ready to play and leave it all out on the floor. This is going to be an exciting second half.
All right, thanks, Erin.
The defender is still applying great ball pressure, Brad.
Daniels receives the ball. He squares up down on the low block.
I tell you, teach your player to face up to get in triple threat position. You can drive, shoot, or you can pass.
Robs him of the ball. Now they work it around the perimeter. On the inside, he gets the shot to fall.
Let's go to the videotape for that one.
Gave it up.
Very soft defensively. No pressure on the basketball.
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with the blocked shot.
It's a fast break possibility. They work it around the perimeter. Got a man in high post. For the bucket.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Olsen handles the feed. The offense gaining great post position down low.
Absolutely. Getting the good inside angle. A poor job defensively. No help. I mean, that is post play at its best.
Lanagona is emotionally pumped up.
He may be in the zone right now, Brad.
He was guarding him tightly, and then he went for the steal. An unsuccessful attempt resulting in a personal foul.
That's why some coaches don't like it when players go for the steal. They end up with fouls or in foul trouble.
On the outside. He pump fakes. There's a nice block from behind, Dick.
Yeah, that's good timing for the defense.
And there's a look at the backcourt comparison, Dick.
I think, Brad, you always want to know how the primary ball handlers are doing. Are they getting their team's quality shots, good opportunities? The team which takes care of these things usually is in a better position to win a game.
Chase receives the pass. Tannum and has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with the blocked shot.
They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works.
USC are on a nice little run at the moment, partner.
They have to remember solid defense leads to good offense, which is what we're seeing right now.
Olsen handles the pass. Looking to move it around the perimeter. Nice move with a face-up.
I'll tell you one thing, Brad. I like guys that are versatile in that post. Facing up is a way to take advantage of three basic moves.
Defensively, low block. Oh, nice job fronting him for the steal.
Terrific job creating the opportunity, and it really converts an offensive transition.
Goes up for two. Perfectly executed. For two. And off the mark. It's stolen.
What a great strip.
Great shot.
That's seven unanswered.
On the dribble, gives it up. Picks off the lazy pass.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
He unloads. Off the rim and no good. That spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beats him to the spot.
Great double team, really explosive. Gave it up. Intercepted. On the dribble, gives it up.
Up and inside.
And we've got a whistle and a foul. Let's check in courtside with Aaron Andrews. Aaron?
Well, guys, after all, this is the NCAA Finals. In talking with both coaches before the game, they figured it would be a close game from start to finish. I'm certainly looking forward to the game's ending.
All right, thanks, Aaron. He takes it away. USC's had great success on the gridiron, but are usually kind of in the middle of the Pac-10 standings for hoops.
They're doing what they can to turn things around. They've hired an ex-NBA coach and feel as though they are on their way.
I think a defensive stop on this possession, Dick, will have this crowd just roaring. Picks off the pass.
Brad, this place will be dusty.
He got fouled and the bucket.
He took it about himself, Brad. Big play, big time score. Oh, young man, be careful. Taunting is definitely a no-no.
That'll definitely rub the opponents the wrong way. He steps up to the line. He sinks it. He intercepts it. Goes up for two. Finger roll.
Watch the replay coming up.
With the fake, ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you gotta have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man. He's got hops like you, man. He got hops like you.
It is pretty similar.
Wow. I didn't realize my partner was a high riser.
He goes to the line for the first time. No doubt about it. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart. Great play to take that to the basket.
Dick, how's he working him defensively?
I tell you, he's trying to front right now. You got three concepts. You can play halfway, you can play behind, or in front. They've decided to play in front, which means you got to get help side.
Gave it up. He's got an open look for the shot. Trying to draw some contact. He puts it in with contact and all. They'll work it around the arc. Three-pointer. He shows the sweet touch.
I want to see that again.
Steals the pass. Well, Mr. Vitale, it looks like we're in for a great finish here.
Hey, down the stretch, there are so many factors that could become the difference maker. Turnovers, missed free throws, rebounding. I wonder what it will come down to in this game.
Jumped in front to take it away. For two. Can't get the shot to drop. Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper.
Double team now. Bad angle.
He pulls the trigger. Rims out.
Look at that spacing.
This is what you're supposed to do down low, is go up strong.
I tell you, that was great post play. Clinic 101 on how to explode to the goal.
How important is it to get to the free throw line?
Well, you know, those bonus points, Brad, you get those simple points. They add up at the end, plus you get people into foul trouble.
Makes his second shot. They work the perimeter. He's open if he wants the shot. He shoots from the top of the circle. Misses from beyond the three-point line. On the outside. Takes the three-pointer. That's definitely not the shot they were looking for, Dick.
That I can guarantee you that he's not the guy they want shooting the ball.
So timeout on the floor, and that gives us a break to go courtside. Here's Aaron.
Well, Brad, this is a great opportunity for the coaches to calm their players down. I'm sure they're anxious, and they may be a little frazzled. Let's see how it all works out, guys.
Aaron's right about that, Dick. I look for something different here coming out of this timeout, Dick.
I wouldn't doubt it, Brad.
That shot makes it a one-point contest.
Hey, it's anybody's game, baby.
There's a high screen. Contact causes the shot to come off.
Tempo of the game, really important here. You want to establish some good tempo.
Sweet fadeaway, Jay.
Gotta think right now. Gotta focus defensively.
Runs him first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind him because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offensive player. And they made an error, obviously. But they don't have the great respect, so they're saying, you know what? Let him get the ball and let him try to beat us.
change in the game plan right now, Dick.
Could be. Got to be ready for anything if you're the opposition.
He unloads a three. You can't go those kind of stretches against a team of this quality and expect to win. Mr. Vitale, how about that State Farm drive of the game?
Oh, Mr. Nestle, this one's superb. The ability to get close enough to the basket and then have the presence of mind to finish off the great play. Wow, what a play.
And the clock stopped with a foul. And we get a look here at our foul and timeout situation.
Hey, Brad, many games are lost because coaches fail to manage the clock. Possession and air timeout situation. Let's see how these coaches fare tonight.
Nick, look at the number of points off turnovers.
I tell you, getting baskets off turnovers is such a great and easy way to score, Brad. You want to maximize these opportunities as much as you can.
How's the front court productivity tonight, Dick?
You know, Brad, basketball is a big man's game. If you have a few on your team and are active and energetic, it makes your team that much better. Ultimately, you want all of your players to be productive, but an inside presence will separate your team from others.
To the charity stripe. He makes the front end of the 1-1. He hits the second shot. That line is really being good to him tonight, Dick.
That line's always good, Brad. These guys just have to make good use of it.
He goes for three. They're really losing confidence with their poor shooting at the time, Dick.
Hey, nothing that a couple of fast break dunks could cure.
There's the turnover situation for the half, Dick.
I'll tell you, the lower the number, the better off your team will be. With too many turnovers, the likelihood of you playing in the game at the end drops significantly.
Second one is no good.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. Steals the ball. All right, Dick, this one's over. One team moves on. One team's got to go home, and that's the sad part about the NCAA tournament.
Well, the better team won because they protected the basketball. They made sure they converted on the free throw line. They did all the little intangibles we talked about, and that was the difference in the game.
The Trojans just wanted it a little bit more in this game, and because of that, they're going to live to play another day, Dick.
Hey, they're on their way to the Elite Eight, Mr. Nestle, where they'll be joined by the 7 best teams in the nation.
It's been a fun game, and as always, my partners alongside have enjoyed you being with us. For Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nestler. Good night, everybody.